Hi, today I will show you how to solder one of my SMD boards. This one is simple USB to serial converter based on FT232RL IC. As you can see, there is just one pin in the S component there and everything else are just passives. Just to make things fun, I will show you how to do this by using cheap unregulated soldering iron. This is very simple 30 watt soldering iron with conical tip. I think it's 3/8 of an inch or something like that, but it doesn't really matter. The only thing that you should avoid is those really thin pointy ones. In addition to soldering iron, you will need some solder wire. For any SMD work, you should try to keep diameter under 0.5 millimeters or 0.02 inch for SI challenged. I prefer to use one with no clean flux, but that is just because I'm too lazy to clean board after. And this particular wire that I will use is lead free, but you can also opt to use lead based solder. I like to keep solder wire in this nice cylindrical container. It just makes it much easier to handle than on a big spool. You also need a nice flux soldering wick. Trust me that you shouldn't be cheapskate on this one. There is huge difference in flux amount and flux quality between no name and even most basic brand. So you don't need to go wild, but don't get the cheapest one. One nice pair of tweezers is also bare necessity because you might go crazy if you need to pick up every single small SMD component by hand. Whether you use curvy ones like this or pointy ones, it's your call. And don't forget magnifying glass. If you are doing some fine pitch work, you must be able to do visual inspection. While you can do it by eye for most of things, using at least 4 times magnifying glass is much easier. I like to start with most complicated part first, and in this case this is our main IC. Just connect a pin or two on each side. Be careful to align everything nicely. Okay, other pin. Quality of this solder connection does not need to be anything special because we are just doing this to keep our IC in place. Now let's flood each side with a lot of solder. Try to melt it at very end so you can be sure that some solder gets sucked under the pins. Don't worry about bridges. The idea is to overwhelm everything with solder, so there is not too much solder. Now let's do the same thing for other side. This is just a bit of combing, so we can be sure that solder got to all pins. Now that we have a solder everywhere, we want to get a wick inside to get excess solder out. Here if you have a bigger tip, it comes in handy, but for this one you will also work. Just be careful to wick as much as you can. Usually you can immediately see whether there are any bridges or a lack of solder, but from my current perspective I am not able to. I will do visual inspection later. So again, other side, we wick away as much as possible. Don't worry that you are going to wick away too much. There is no chance that you are able to do that. If you have wicked away everything but there is a stubborn bridge there, you can get in with a bit more solder, and that additional solder usually gets the bridge out. Now I will do visual inspection. Everything looks fine. Beware, by doing this you are probably heating up chip a bit over his spec. However, I never managed to destroy one this way. What you do end up destroying is beauty of your board, because you will see traces of excessive heat on it. Next in line are small passives. C1 is 10 nanofarads, 100 nanofarads are C2 and C3. And we have in same line R1, which is 1K. These are 0805 components, so they are not too small. The way how you can solder them is by putting a bit of solder on each pad, just enough. This is probably a bit over. Okay. So then we take our component and we reheat the solder that we put here. And let's just tuck it a bit more, and component is soldered. Let's do same for other capacitor. So we take, just take so component a bit, push it down, and that's that. So reflow component. Oops, this is tombstoning. After everything is soldered on one side, it's really easy to solder other side also. Now let's do the same with ferrite, LED
and the last capacitor.
Only real care should be exercised with LED, especially if you are dealing one with which you haven't dealt before. This one has a cathode marked with one small line. I'm not sure how visible it is here, but same manufacturer can use the same marking but for anode. Now the other side. Connectors go last. With USB plug, it's usually quite trivial to solder it. Just align it and get the shield on the other side soldered first. We can just float this with solder. It gets much easier if you have slots from your PCB manufacturer. Okay, now we can deal with the upper SMD pins. And last one is a female header. Let's just quickly check alignment. Looks fine. And here is our device completely soldered. As you can see, even with old unregulated dirty soldering iron, you can solder most of SMD components without any major issues. Of course, if you are doing things with nice, clean and temperature regulated soldering iron, everything gets much easier.